So to get us started today, we'll be doing The Night Has a Thousand Eyes. This is traditionally a vocal tune. When it was written for the 1948 film of the same name. And the lyrics are romantic by nature, but there are some pretty deep undertones of the occult in the lyrics. One of the lyrics says, "Don't whisper things you don't mean, for words deep down inside can be seen by the night. The night has a thousand eyes, and it knows a truthful heart from one that lies." So when we entered the bebop era, a lot of people and composers and arrangers took this tune and they switched fields. They would go between a mambo to a swing. One of the biggest tunes that I took for influence to play this would be John Coltrane's record, The Night Has a Thousand Eyes, or Elvin Jones on the drum set. And so this follows an AAB form. There's two A sections and the B section. And so tonight we'll be going between both the mambo and the swing feel. During the solo sections, we'll be doing just the swing feel, so you don't get too lost. And that's about all I have. So without further ado, The Night Has a Thousand Eyes.
Thank you.
So, for our second tune, this will be Sincerely Diana. This is not a very common song, especially for jazz standards. Actually, I did a lot of digging, and I only found the sheet music through a handwritten half sheet that Emmy Stefanoff, a local pianist, sent to me. And this is actually the only song that I can readily find drum sheet music, but no chord change or melody. So if you hit the chart, I have it. Wayne Shorter composed this tune for the Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers record, A Night in Tunisia. For this record, essentially, Art Blakey wanted to showcase new young talent. He had Wayne Shorter, Lee Morgan, and Bobby Timmons in the band. And each of them kind of brought their own different composition style for the record. Wayne Shorter's, for this tune especially, was weird. Most tunes, especially for jazz standards, it's about 32 bars, 16 bars, 12 bars, stuff like that. This is actually a 30-bar form, and during the recording, most times soloists will do the chorus once, twice. Actually, it descends in order. The first soloist does it three times, second soloist twice, last soloist one time through, and then in this recording, Art Blakey takes a free-form jazz solo, which tonight I have been working on a transcription of it. So the drum solo tonight is actually stroke for stroke, as best as I can find a version of this solo that Art Blakey did. Actually, Dave Rudolph, my instructor at UT, and I have both individually worked on the solo. So we've compared notes, compared different sticking patterns, and this is about as close as it's gonna get. So, Sincerely Diana.
Thank you.
So Ray Noble was actually an English band leader from the dance era, moved to New York City in 1934, and Cherokee was originally intended to be a movement and a suite about the Indian American nations. Actually, the lyrics translate to being a love song for a Native American woman. During the bebop era, that was thrown out the window, and it was actually used as a great song to improvise over. Oftentimes, a lot of people would use this as a fast avenue to improvise. Since the B section is in a kind of like a wonky key originally, that was kind of like a big flex to be like, I can solo over hard changes and a very fast tempo, look at me go. Clifford Brown, his version from the 1955 album Studying Brown is one of like the biggest hallmarks for the tune originally. Some people will perform a song about 400 BPM, which is about that fast. We're not gonna do that. I like songs that groove a lot more. So actually, for my inspiration for this tune, an Australian drummer named Alexander Flood, I've been following him a lot on social media, and he actually did this for one of his recitals at Adelaide University. And he did it just down a little bit, and I took a lot of ideas, a lot of phrasing ideas, and put it into my own playing. So we'll start this tune, Cherokee. Thank you. So we're going to end tonight with the Chick Corea tune, Captain Marvel. So Chick Corea composed this song for the 1972 album of the same name, Captain Marvel, for Stan Getz. During this era, Stan Getz was trying to get more into the jazz fusion side of things, so he actually hired a bunch of new, much like Art Blakey, new up-and-coming artists of the era. He has Stanley Clark on bass, Chick Corea on piano, and he really filled his band with people who are really innovating at this time. So Chick Corea actually, fun fact, is also a local. He lives in Clearwater, Florida, and made his name for himself playing for Miles Davis, making collaborations with him. Captain Marvel is based in the feel of a Brazilian samba, and so for this tune I'll be doing batucada, essentially is more of a snare drum and floor tom kind of solo for part of my solo, and then I'll also be just kind of building a variant off of that. And before I go any further, thank you all for coming. I really appreciate it. A lot of hard work has gone into this. Big thank you to the faculty and staff at University of Tampa, Dr. Blackburn, Dr. Daniel, Dr. Eicher, everyone who's helped me get through here, my ensemble, who I've been playing a lot with for the past few years. And all of you. So thank you, and enjoy this last tune, Captain Marvel. Thank you. so much.